Ladies and gentlemen, please stay standing as we welcome our senior class president, Cameron Singleton, to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Hi. Will you all please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
And now singing our national anthem, seniors Victoria Melcher, Ariel Hunter, Sam Miller, and Caitlin Rowland.
So good. be seated. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Arkansas Arts Academy's 2022 graduation. We are glad you are here and especially grateful that you have shared your students with us for their high school experience. I am Jamie Dale, the assistant principal on this campus, but before this year, I was the 11th grade English teacher, among other things. I have had the pleasure of having most of your students in my class, or more than one class, and I know how amazing they are in many ways. To the graduates, I would like to share a quote from actress Kerry Washington. "Your life is your story, and the adventure ahead of you is the journey to fulfill your own purpose and potential." While that probably seems scary right now with all the changes in your life that are happening, embrace it. Embrace all of it. Embrace the adventure, embrace the hard times, embrace the good times. Embrace them all, because all of them shape who you are. Travel. Any of you that have been in my class, I say that over and over. Travel and experience many cultures around the world. Experience all that the world has to offer and make many memories. Congratulations to all of you, and I wish you the best on your new adventure. I'd like to welcome our CEO, Dr. Allison Roberts.
Thank you, parents, community, family, for joining us tonight. Students, this is a very exciting opportunity for you to finally feel the success of your first educational milestone. Congratulations. Parents, you did it. From the moment you packed that first kindergarten backpack and the pencil case and you sent them off to kindergarten, your diligence and efforts in making sure they could write their name and know their letters transcended into them entering into high school, and now you're at the point where you're walking across the stage and celebrating their educational success. So congratulations. Students, as you leave school, I hope you can reflect on what a very unique opportunity you've had at Arkansas Arts Academy. A school of choice that you and your parents chose to be at. And I hope that when you leave and you walk across the stage as you enter into adulthood, you also can reflect on the lessons and experiences and great opportunities you've had at this school. When you get your diploma after the ceremony, there's going to be little cards like this that I want you to pick up a few of. And on one side, it's this beautiful building that you've been to school in every day. And then also there's a little note on the other side. And I want you to hopefully put this in your wallet or put this in a location that as you go through life and you've got some hard choices to make, or you're in a challenging situation and you don't quite know what to do, then you can pull this out and reflect on some of the experiences you had here at Arkansas Arts Academy. Whether it was a teacher that made an impact on you, whether it was a particular assignment or a performance that you really felt successful in, your friends, use this as an opportunity to reflect. And I hope that you take the arts with you. So on this card, it says arts. And they're really, I love acronyms and I love spelling and word puzzles, but arts, aspire. So I hope you aspire to greatness, aspire to things that you only feel like you could, it's a dream away. Aspire to do even greater than you can even think of. Aspire to show yourself that you can accomplish anything. The next one is resilient, for R. Changes happen in life. Changes happen all of the time. And as an adult, you're going to see that more and more frequently. I want you to be resilient in life and know that no matter what changes come about, that you will survive and you will excel. You've had a lot of changes in your educational career, staff changes, administration changes, but what has survived is your resiliency. You are successfully graduating high school, and you are resilient, and you will be resilient, whatever your path may be after you leave the stage. The next one, T, is for true. I hope that you in your life remain true to who you are. Pick friends that support you and never feel the need to change who you are to fit into any other environment. And then the last is really something I hope you hang on to, is a service. Be in service of others, be in service to your community, but also be service to yourself. Make sure you're making choices that support who you are. And make sure that when you have a moment that you're not quite sure, pick up the phone and call your parents. Pick this card up out of wherever you've placed it. And remember that you've got an incredible support system that's helping you and has helped you along the way. Again, congratulations. I'm so proud of each of you and the journeys you lay ahead. Keep us posted on where you go and your incredible future that's ahead of you. Thank you. Now I have the pleasure of introducing our senior class salutatorian, Roddy Little.
Well, before I begin, I'd like to say a few things. If I'm entirely honest, I do not expect anyone to remember this speech a year from now, or even a month at that. With that said, I'd like to say what I think is best at this moment. You did it, congratulations! You've all reached the end of your high school career, despite the chaotic nature of this year and the previous three. You made it, you should all be proud. Now that your high school career is done, it's time for you to shed the skin of your past and look to the future. Focus on your dreams, your goals, and your aspirations. Strive towards them. Strive towards greatness. And strive towards what makes you happy. I know for a fact I'm in a room brimming with talented people. Every single one of you has something you are amazing at. And all of you have something that makes you happy. These skills, hobbies, or quirks, these differences between us all are what makes us amazing. These talents are what will push you towards greatness. Find your dream, fight for it, strive for it, and whatever you do, don't let someone else take it from you. A dream, a goal, some aspiration, big or small, selfish or altruistic, will guide you for the rest of your life. If you don't have a dream or fight for one, you will find yourself serving someone else to achieve their dream. I suggest making your own path. Fighting for your own dream. Start a fire within you no one could ever hope to extinguish. When you walk off campus today, never to return, remember your success. Celebrate it. Enjoy yourself. But once that celebration is over, it's time for action. Your future is within your hands. Obtain your dream and don't let anyone or anything get in your way. You don't need to remember these words, but remember to take that action. All of you will always have a place in my heart. Now, I am super excited to introduce the coolest person I've ever known, our class valedictorian, Willem Patrick Pumavong Mate.
This one's a bit long. Graduates, soon will come a time when you wonder how you ever had any, as the strain of adulthood tears at you relentlessly. I'm sure this is a feeling many of you are already far too familiar with. When we were little, we enjoyed the niceties of existence, oblivious to how abhorrent life can really be. Unbeknownst to us, it was the big people who shielded us from the hard-to-swallow conundrums of being human, who gave us the opportunity to savor the simple things in life, all while fighting their own hidden battles. To that, I say thank you to the big people, as we all should. If not parents, than grandparents or uncles or aunts or teachers or anyone who really showed that they cared when you were budding and vulnerable, just ripe for being gobbled up by a world of hungry wolves. Now, I don't claim to know everyone's situation or their toils. Heck, I don't really claim to have anything on anybody. That's why I feel I'm not in any particular position to bore you with the same insipid platitudes espoused by every valedictorian in their graduation speech. But if there's one piece of advice I feel I need to reiterate back into the world, not for any of you, of course, but just for me, it would be simply to chill out. There's a little saying I'm sure we're all familiar with one way or another. Yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, but today is a gift. That is why it is called the present. Now, the first time I heard this, it didn't really stick. Granted, I was like maybe 4, and I was watching Kung Fu Panda, so I didn't really care about the parts where they were talking because that's boring, as evident in the way you're all sitting there staring at me blankly, smiling and muttering to yourselves, will this guy ever shut up? Recently, by the power of my generation's collective nostalgia and my For You page on Instagram, the quote has navigated its way back to me. I've been digesting it for a while, but it wasn't really until now that I've gotten anything from it, seeing as I was so concerned with just about everything and anything these last, like, what, 10 months? Heck, even while writing this, there were many things just eating at me that really shouldn't have been. I worried for a world many miles ahead of me and mourned for one many miles back. It was tiring and no way to live life. But to make a long story short, everything turned out A-okay. I'm okay, you're okay, it's okay. Life has a way of working out in the end. It's funny like that. Look, I get it. Optimism is difficult. That's why we have pessimists. These aren't feelings you can just discard at a moment's notice without much thought. Like a piece of chewed up gum that started out great, but got a little too hard and made your jaw hurt. Recognize it's okay to have problems. Everyone has them. They just come in different flavors. Take those baby steps. Once you tolerate the struggle, you may come to love it. Or you may realize it's really nothing at all, because the universe doesn't have bad days, only you do. Maybe then you'll realize happiness isn't everything it's chalked up to be, and it's okay to settle for just being okay. But until that moment of clarity, when you say to yourself, hey, maybe everything's not so bad, maybe I am okay, you just gotta keep on trucking, because living's a problem whose answers come when you aren't looking for them. So in the meantime, just smile and enjoy it. It's okay if high school wasn't what you wanted it to be, or if uncertainty about the future tears at your every sinew and tendon. There are plenty of things in the world worth smiling about, even if that only thing is that you woke up this morning. I hope that this resonated with at least one person, as hackneyed and cliche as it may be. Maybe one day soon someone will realize that Master Oogway was right, and there's no sense in worrying, because in the grand scheme of things, there really is no grand scheme. It's just here and now, baby. And if nobody's better from it, well then so be it. I'm just some guy with a microphone talking on my mouth. As we graduates move forward, we'll find ourselves further entrenched in this newfangled real world. Some of us are lucky enough to be afforded one last sliver of time before we're truly grown-ups. I know I'll take this time between now and when I leave the nest to be a kid just one last time. I'll spend it with my family and friends, because that's what matters most to me at this moment. When someone asks me, how are you doing? I'll smile and I'll say, I'm okay. These are the okay days, when nothing is awry and sailing is the smoothest. The struggle for greatness has taken a back seat, and now we can all just worry about being okay. Okay? Okay.
Sorry, we're all a little nervous. They're coming now. We'd like to welcome Dr. Riley from our school board as she's going to confer the diplomas with the assistance of Dr. Appleton. Okay. Willem Patrick Pumavong Mate. Roddy Anthony Little. Cameron Shea Singleton. Caitlin Blythe Rowland. Victoria Isabel Melchor. Ariel Lynn Hunter. Samuel Aaron Miller. Raven Quinn Allen. Kobe Sean Barker. Anna Marie Bisbee. Hayden Robert Blocker. Jordan Lee Bergner. Javon Dior Carr. Cecilia Katasi. Tyler Everest Cherry Key. Arwen Cass Choate. Gianna Grace Corbino. Noah Henry Craycraft. Audrey Colette Cusick. Leslie Yannette Diaz. Annabelle Christine Driggs. Brindley Duarte. Katarina Elise Engel. Piper Elizabeth Marcel Engel. Callie Nicole Erskine. Julian Eldon Francis. Kara Isabel Francis. Brady Nicholas Fuller. Sapphire Gibson. Lily Jane Gretzmeyer. Emma Grace Hamby. Lena Nakaya Hart. Tyler Michael Havens. Juan Carlos Hernandez. Adley Lynn Holland. Eden Josephine Jimenez. Riley Michaela Kirby. Isabella Grace Klutz Davis. Jacqueline Ann Kaprovic. John Robert Lang. Madison Lorraine Lastovica. Emma Grace Lawson. Riley Allen Lewis. Amber Mate. Caleb Stephen Mock. Caitlin Louise Melick. Genevieve Rose Miller. Gabriel Clay Morgan. Alexandra Morale. Mason Luis Murillo. Alyssa Carolyn Newby. Kristen Mackenzie Pafford. Hannah Nicole Phillips. Owen Michael Palumbo. Tevin Charles Poole. Hannah Louise Riley. Olivia Chow Yong Shork. John Michael C. Luke Bennett C. Michaela Kylie Smith. Sydney Clarice Smith. Evan Quinn Stiles. Leah Nicole Stroud. Sierra Paige Stroud. Jada Isabel Swanson. Sergio Antonio Torres. Jaden Allen Wayne. Theo Webb. Jenna Leanne Wood. Zoe Michelle Wyman. I'd like to welcome Dr. Appleton back to the podium.
Can we just give them another round of applause? So with this ceremony comes many firsts and lasts. It's the last time you'll walk across this stage as students at Arkansas Arts Academy. It's the first time that I, as a principal, have had seniors, and it's the first time I've had to decide whether I should be looking at them or looking at you guys. So I'm gonna try to do half and half here. I just wanna say how proud we are of you. As we talk about the last 3 years and how so much has changed and how we've gone virtual and we've come back and we've been here. You sitting here today and making it across the stage, that means a lot to me because it means that you stuck through a whole lot, okay? And I just wanna say thank you for such a wonderful year. We wish you the very best as you move forward. Wherever you set your sails for the horizon, may the sun be in your face and the wind at your back and the seas calm. May you enjoy the journey ahead. At this time, parents, we're going to ask that you remain seated. We're going to do our recessional and get our seniors out to the commons area to take a couple of photos. At that time, we will release you all, and then we can begin our celebration. So at this time, seniors, if you will stand, and we will begin our recessional. Thank you.